I'm willing to share with everyone, with the world, okay? So, I was at a friend's house, and I saw this piece of wood that had been tossed about out there in the weather. It's been warped by weather. And I said, that's kind of interesting. You know, it's had a hole in it, some nail holes, and been tossed. So I'm sure it's going to find its way in somebody's fireplace. So I asked the guy, hey, can I have that? He said, sure. take it away from this house. So I eventually saw this as being the sky and the sea with the sun that's flowering. I have the aluminum wire at home already, so it's a matter of just drilling a whole bunch of holes in the sun, weaving the wire through, you know, weaving the wire through.
Oh, that must be
tough.
No?
Okay. You know, you're just drilling up holes until you have the effect, you know, in the sculptural piece that you want. And then when you weave through, then you just begin to create the panels that fall. And that's done all by hand. You know, just sit there with a glass of wine and watching TV and there you go.
It makes it sound easy.
Yeah. But you know, a lot of people say, ah, that's a lot of work. But this kind of stuff, work part of it kind of disappears. You know, when you get into it, it disappears. So it's a two-piece piece, I'd say, and turbulent times. I'm sorry, the sun flowers. I chose the color because, you know, Seattle is kind of gray, you know, in general, so I wanted something that was brilliant and alive and uplifted the spirit. So there it is. I think when I walk into my house and see this piece, it's a bright day.
It brightens your day.
Look at the blue on this, the backdrop. And look what she's doing. She's dancing, she's joyous. Mm-hmm. And that's what this is supposed to create as well, from my perspective.
It's a good,
side by side.
Yeah, it really is.
You did that on purpose.
So I guess I call myself probably an abstract impressionist kind of guy. You know, it's supposed to, it's true abstract, I guess, you're not supposed to know that this is a sun. And maybe this is still abstract because a young lady came in here yesterday and she said, oh, I don't see the sun at all, I see a dress.
A dress?
A dress. Uh-huh. And this is just an ornament on the dress.
Okay, look at it, that's the shoulders and the fingers down.
Yeah, that's what she's showing.
Interesting. I saw the sunflower as a flower first, uh-huh. And then now I'm seeing it as the sun flowering. So yeah, it has a whole lot of different dimensions to it.
So that's unless there are any questions, that's all I have to say about that.
So how many other pieces would you say that you've made that deal with nature? And is nature a major inspiration for some of your pieces?
No, not at all. Not at all. I've done that's a good question. You comes to me to go back in memory and nothing really comes out.
You use a lot of blues and you use things that have different skies and different textures in it.
Well, I have this one piece at home that's a piece of tile. You know, that's about, I don't know, about this long, about that tall. Probably one of Jay's throwaways. Jay's an architect, but you know, these architects, there's this annual sale on Capitol Hill where the architects have given all their surplus, you know, things that they've ordered from buildings as samples, and they sell them. So they give them away. So there's this piece of tile about like this. There use pieces of metal on it, like aluminum piece on here, piece of iron here, and another painted piece of metal here. You know, kind of painted on it, and they look kind of interesting together.
That's good.
I could show you on my tablet. So So, but that's kind of muted colors. Sorry, the backdrop, the tile itself is kind of dirt color.
Okay.
But the metal is like silver with a black line going through it. Kind of a very dark gray with yellow painted on the edges, on the outside edges. And then another color of metal with yellow painted on the outside edges.
Is this going to be part of the exhibit for later on this month, or is that going to be a piece that we're going to see soon?
Yeah, I'm bringing it in. Yeah, sure.
Now, give us a little bit of give us a little headway of the two pieces that you're submitting for the annual exhibition.
No, we don't want that. We want that to be a secret.
Can we just say the name?
No, it's a secret.
No teaser?
No teaser. No spoiler. No teaser.
Ernie, can you tell us about the abstract process? And you're creating art. How does that occur? Do you use like a sketchbook and write down some of your ideas and kind of test those out as you're going, or?
Yeah, sometimes I can be influenced by a pattern in this wood. So from a pattern, I'll get an idea, so I might sketch it out, but typically, and it's good to have a sketch, but normally for me, after I begin to transition from the sketch to the real thing, it changes.
Yeah.
Because what begins to happen is, you're having this conversation with yourself, one thing is informing something a little bit differently, and you say, I want to go here. Now let me go here. So, and you might end up with something that could be decent.
Is it a tactile? Are you following a tactile a prompt? Are you like, I don't like how this physically feels, or are you following like an emotional prompt says?
It's more emotional. The physical feel is almost introduced first. I don't think I've ever introduce the tactile in the end. This probably happened first. Either in the mind, so I didn't even sketch it. I just went straight from this board to this thing. I said, okay, that's sky. Now I need, wouldn't it be nice to have water? because on its own, to me, that's not so interesting.
Right.
When you add it, with you give it a different scale, to me, it looks more abstract.
So you almost felt an emotional lack, like something was missing.
Yes.
And then went out to figure out, how do I create whatever that is that's missing?
Some people ask, when I show up on my tablet, some of the art, they'll ask, on a piece of that, maybe half that size, maybe an horizontal, I'll put a piece of color of red, small strip of red, maybe a small strip of another color on the bottom. What's that for? Well, like I said, it's the process. You step back and look at what you create. It's just something missing. So what is it? Well, then again, this that. Conversation with yourself. I sit there and I say, what colors would be interesting to make this balance properly, so keep it interesting. And sometimes it's a little bit. You're going to try a red, try a yellow, mix it. And then, but when you're satisfied, that's it. Leave it. Drop it. Walk away.
Kind of like writing poetry. Because I'm a poet and I don't know where I'm going. The first line sort of comes to me like a pattern that you see or an excerpt. And a first interesting line comes in my head and I'll go like, oh, that's interesting. You should do a poem on that. But I never know where it's going, and at the end it's... But sometimes years later I come back and go, wait a minute, one line actually finishes. You never know.
Oh, so, yeah.
With these, there's more of a feeling of closure and completion when you get to the end of it. Because you really, I don't think you could change that song.
I would not change that.
I wouldn't either.
But I have had pieces that I have changed. You know, for me, typically, the more apparent stuff that's in it, the least I'm satisfied with it. Mm-hmm. I'm kind of a, that's a Japanese term, minimalist.
Yeah.
I'm a minimalist in my head. Mm-hmm. You know, and the results. Minimal, the less I do, the better it can essentially work. But I gotta put the energy into it to realize that.
Right. And speaking of Japanese, this could be compared to Kintsugi, which is taking something that's broken, which is what you did, has cut holes and nails in it, it's all a throwaway, right? And you made something beautiful out of it. Okay, so Kintsugi is, if you have a pot, particularly ancient one, or very valuable old one that gets broken, they melded that together with gold or silver.
Oh, yeah.
And it becomes even more beautiful and more valuable. Mm.
Interesting.
And it's a, yeah, that's an old.
How do you spell that?
Kintsuga.
Okay, I want to write that down.
Stop.
Here. Yeah. And do that after we're done with that. Oh, there you go.
Send me a how do you.